Our project work is on Shalimar Garden. It's a group. We divided our project on two parts, to historicize the garden and to look at the present positions of the garden. So our collaborator there in Boston dealt with its history, and we here in BCU visited this garden on February 23, 2017, and we collected their information, images, and we mostly dealt with the contemporary positions of the garden. So now I am turning to its location. The location. This garden is located 5 kilometers away from the main city of Lahore, in GT Road, Mohanpura. Mohanpura is a famous place for the garden, and this is the close view of the Shalimar Bagh. And now I'm turning to the really close view. It's identification of its key features. This is the main street view of the garden from the down to top. These are the three terraces. The first terrace on the down is called Parabash, meaning the store of pleasure. It contains buildings, flowers, fountains, king residence. And the middle level terrace is called Faizbakhsh, which means the bestower of goodness, the bestower of relaxation. And this also have fountains, towers, trees, buildings, and there on the top is the lower terrace, which is called the Hayatbakhsh, the bestower of life. The third terrace is the only terrace where the commoners were allowed, while in the other terraces they were not allowed. In the third terrace, the king was supposed to have the walls. So I'm turning to its history of the garden. This garden was constructed in 1641 by Shah Jahan, the Mughal Emperor. This was completed in half years. And the idea of the construction of this garden conceived first by the governor of the Punjab, Persian governor, under the Mughal ruler. And why this location chose? You should know that Lahore has its own history, its own importance, and empire needs glory. Empire show their glory in architecture. So this location was suitable for construction of the garden because this land was fertile and also had a garden, the Mia of family. And for the defense purpose, on the west of this garden, a fort was constructed in the reign of Akbar. So the consolidation glory was the main purpose of this garden. So, this garden almost old, some 380 years old, and still it has a beauty, and it's a very nice place. So, during the Sikh rule, some buildings were vandalized. Material of the buildings were sold in the town because it seems sort of against of the Mughals, and that is its own cause. And in British period, the repairing the maintenance process still continued, but something introduced, and many buildings were removed and many trees were removed. But in post-partition period, it was under the Mia family. The Mia family, which provided the site to the Mughals, and in return, the Shah Jahan granted the guardianship of this garden to their family. That family administered this garden more than 300 years. But in 1962 of post-partition, the youth nationalized it because it is a conception that this family opposed the martial law, and they were performing the light of festival in this garden which was opposed by the youth. In 1981, it was declared a World Heritage Site by UNESCO. Then in 2007, UNESCO funded $15 million for its preservation and maintenance, and Pakistan government also provided money for to secure, to preserve this place. Now turning to the culture of this garden. You can assume that from the name of the terraces, the beauty of the terraces, the meaning of the name of the Shalimar, light of the moon, and you will understand after when my collaborator will show the images with the explanation and details how it was beautiful and how was a nice place for royal ladies, for king, and this garden also have a symbolic meaning. The king residence is on the top. The aspects that the Mia family were performing a 10th anniversary of a Sufi named Shah Hussain, the light of festival in this garden. So sort of cultural activities are taking place in this garden today. Dinners, concerts, TV, film shooting is a site for excellency visits, like Shairan when he visited this garden in 1915. Then it was renovated, it was rehabilitated to some extent. Still it's there is a work of renovation started. It's open for the public, and a very large number of people visited this place, and still it's have a beauty and its glory. So,
hello, I'm Zafar Abbas, and the topic of my presentation is Shalimar Garden. Now I'm going to describe the key features of Shalimar Garden. Actually, there are certain key features in which include buildings, fountains, cascades, trees, and plants, etc. First of all, I would like to describe buildings of Shalimar Garden. Now, this is the main gate of Shalimar Garden, and after this, this is second entrance gate which comes in next after the main gate. This is fourth pavilion, which is also known as Arz Teki. This building is actually used for solving the disputes among the peoples. This is security tower, and these security towers are constructed in each corner of this garden. There are three terraces in this garden, which are existed now. The total terraces of this garden was 7, in which 4 had vanished with the passage of time because of overpopulation. Now, this first level terrace, this is known as Farabash. This is middle level terrace, this is known as Farazbash. This is low level terrace and known as Hayatbash. These are the buildings that located on first level terrace. Queen Residence, King's Residence, Central Pavilion, William Morris Building, and Nagar Khanna. These are the buildings and features which located on second level terrace. This is Royal Throne, and just in front of the Royal Throne, this is a bouncing stage which was used to dance, to provide prayer for kings and other courtiers and nobles. This is Case or Marble Waterfall. This is actually located on second level terrace and connected with first level terrace through central pavilion. This is White Pavilion, and they are two in number and used for royal guests. These buildings are known as Red Sandstone and used for musicians. This is Canal Place. The actual name of this is Saman Bagan. There are 420 holes in which lights and tunnels of work illuminated at night, and this is Royal Bagh. These buildings are located on third level terrace. Delhi Gate, Lahore Gate, Charity Buildings. Delhi Gate is located on eastern side of this terrace, and Lahore Gate is located on western side of this terrace, just opposite to Delhi Gate. And the Charity Building is used to provide money to the needy and poor people. And this is the overview of this terrace. These are another feature in which include trees, plants, shrubs, etc. In which include apple tree, orange tree,